I'm going to show you how to zoom into an eye using PowerDirector. Let's take a closer look at this effect. I have a clip of a lady opening her eye on track one, and I need a snapshot of the last frame so that I can create a zoom. So you want to move your playhead to the end of the clip, and then you want to go to the snapshot button and left click that. Then you want to select the location on your device where you want to save the clip. And you want to give it a name and click on save. Now we want to add the snapshot behind the clip on track two. So we're going to place our cursor over it, hold down our left mouse button and drag it down to track two right behind that clip. Now we're going to change the duration of this clip. So we're going to click on duration and we're going to change it to 18 frames. And hit enter. Now we're going to go ahead and place the clip that we want to show through the eye on track one. So we'll hold our cursor over it, hold down our left mouse button and drag it down to track one right behind the first clip. And we want to go ahead and create a small segment at the beginning. So we'll go ahead and place our cursor right at the end of the snapshot. We'll left click on the clip that we want to show through the transition. And then we'll click on split. Now we need to create a zoom of the snapshot. So we're going to left click on the snapshot. And we're going to change the duration because we want it to be a little bit longer. And we'll hit enter. Now we're going to go to tools, pan and zoom. And we're going to choose pan and zoom. And we need to customize that. So we're going to click on Motion Designer. And first we need to go ahead and have the first position to be the full frame. So we're gonna change the X and Y positions to center them. And we're gonna bring the scale to 1. And now we need to move our playhead to the end. And we need to drag the arrow to the middle of the eye. And then we want to go ahead and use the nodes to make it as small as possible. And you can make any adjustments that you want to make as well. And once you're done, you can go ahead and click on OK. Now we want to add a mask to the snapshot so that we can see the other clip through the center of the eye. So we're going to go to Tools. And we're going to go to Mask Designer. Here we want to choose the feather circle. And we're going to click on Invert Mask. And we want to bring our feather up a little bit. And now you can use these nodes to go ahead and center the mask over the eye. I already know the position and the scale that I want to use, so I'm just going to go ahead and type those in. You may need to uncheck maintain aspect ratio based on the shape of the eye. You may not need to, that's up to you. Now that we have the mask on top of the pupil, we need to make it scale up along with the eye. If we go ahead and move our playhead, you'll see that the image zooms up, but the mask doesn't. So we need to go ahead and keyframe that out. So we're going to add a position keyframe and a scale keyframe right at the beginning. And then we're going to move up about 2 or 3 frames. And we'll resize the mask. And you want to keep doing that until you get all the way to the end. When you got all your keyframes done, you go ahead and click on OK. Now, if you play this back, you'll notice that when you get to the transition, it jumps from black to color. So we don't want the pupil to just change like that. We want it to kind of blend in. So to do that, we're going to go ahead and left click on this small clip that we created here. And we're going to go to Fix Enhance. And we're going to select Color Adjustment. And here we're going to change our exposure all the way to 0. And we're going to bring our brightness all the way down to negative 100. And now you can see that the pupil looks black. Next, we're going to go ahead and close this out. And to help blend it in, we're going to go to the transition room. We're going to go to general. And we're going to use a fade transition. We're going to left click and we're going to drag it down between these two clips. Now the transition is a bit too long, so we're going to click on duration. And I'm just going to change it to a half a second and hit enter. Now, if we play this back, we should see the pupil stay black and then it should blend and fade to the clip that's underneath it. So that looks good right now, but we want to add a little bit of flizzer to it. So we want to add some motion blur. So we're going to left click on the snapshot. We're going to go to effects. We're going to make sure that we're on the style effect. And we're going to go to style. And we're going to go to radial blur. We'll left click, hold down our left mouse button, and drag it down to the snapshot. And so you can see around it now that it has a little bit of a blur, like a motion blur going on there. And you can play this back here. Now, if you don't like the speed, you can slow it down or speed it up, make it look how you want it to. So to do that, you can left click on the snapshot, place your cursor at the end, hold down your control button, hold down your left mouse, and if you want it to be slower, you can drag it out this way. If you want it to be faster, you can drag it to the left. And then you can play it back again. I got my eye on you. You can use masks to make other cool transitions too. If you want to create a motion mask transition, check out this tutorial. Don't forget to smash my cartoon face to subscribe, hit me up with your comments, and drop me a like down below.